Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. For the great greeting, Lil Hawk. It's a PSA announcement. They say they care, but they really don't. Kamikaze twist and turn like Inferno. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Happy Friday. Oh, we are back, ladies and gentlemen.
Different ways, don't say you're bored. Don't say you help many kids and then you close the door.
You ain't no better than politicians, you hypocrites.
Use your power to make a change and make the difference.
All this talking you're saying, it ain't saying much. We don't really care, ladies and gentlemen. Is it really though?
They say they care. We know they
happy
really
don't. It's Friday.
All for show. They do it all for show. They set the world on fire. They let it burn slow. They set the world on fire. They let it burn slow.
Tara, good
day. They let it burn slow. Yeah, they set the world on fire. They let it burn slow. You left arm in, you take your left arm out. You put your right hand in, and then you shake it all about.
Hey, you do this hokey pokey, then you
break you on down.
Hey.
Basic and practice on your greatness. Life don't work like that, gotta be amazing. I've been down and now I know what it takes to be on top right now. I know I'm your favorite. This is hip-hop and politics and relevance. This ain't J6, but it's an insurrection. I took Jack Smith and Bonnie Willis. Prosecutions to the next level. I got MAGA triggered in a state of shock, cause the time has come. The Brown Boys got 22 for seditious conspiracy. What happened to back the blue?
He told you to march through the Capitol. He would hear you. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, we are back.
He wanted to hang Pence too. You said Biden would lose, he beat Trump too. You said you wanted the truth,
and now you got Zeus.
So who's the Marxist and communist and fascist? Let's see it.
And we know they do. They refuse to accept the results of a free election. All right, it's showtime, ladies and gentlemen. Good morning, attacking. I see all of you. You know what time it is, ladies and gentlemen. It's showtime. All right.
It's like I'm stuck in time. It's like a curse. And I can't escape it. It's like deja vu. It's me, Zeus.
Yes.
It's deja vu when I'm running up these racks.
Good morning, Miss Boss Diva.
I'll be back.
See ya.
It's deja vu.
My partner is Ron.
First class. It's like every week I gotta take out the trash. I'm on top of my game, ahead of class. You can tell that I made it. Look at my grass.
Cars in the garage. Sharks feast
gas. I play the game so long,
I won't finish last. Sitting in my living room, screaming how we made it. This is how it's supposed to happen when you're rich and famous. The algorithm turned me to a maniac. I guess we going viral cause my zodiac. I got all these numbers on my spreadsheet. Bitchman is my bestie. And if they is my ex, that mean they left me. They don't get replies if they text me. I say it with my chest cause I mean it. Got a lot of confidence and I'm conceited. Call me the master with a new whip. I'ma take off in a spaceship. Here we go.
Gone into Zeus's life and get realistic.
Yes.
That shit was radical.
Very radical.
It was horrible. I'm like, you've gone, Zeus has gone way off the rails.
It's like deja vu. It's like deja vu.
Right.
It's like deja vu.
Right, right, right.
It's like deja vu.
Right, right, right.
thank you, conservatives. All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to today's morning show. We are once again back in the lion's den. Oh, yeah. All right. Happy Friday, everyone. I hope you all had a nice night after yesterday's wild experience on this app. All right. So let's get some of the housekeeping taken care of. All right. For those of you who do not know who I am, I go by the name of Zeus, or as some like to say, Triple H. And why do they call me Triple H, ladies and gentlemen? Well, it's quite simple. The first H is because I'm honest. There's nobody more honest than me on this app. I'm the most honest person on social media, all right? The next H, ladies and gentlemen, is because I'm humble. There's nobody more humble than me, all right? If I get it wrong, I will be the first to apologize. And I got something to say. I actually do need to apologize. Yeah, I did say that I wasn't going to mention some names yesterday after I had an interesting episode in the Closet of Truth. I think I said something like, I won't mention Stacey and Janae's name. However, due to a recent change in events, I'm actually going to have to mention those names. So I know you hate that I did it. I know, but I'm going to do it. I got to do it. I'm so sorry, okay? So, the next H, ladies and gentlemen, I know, but we're going to have to talk about the elephant in the room, so to speak, all right? And the next H, ladies and gentlemen, is because I am and will always remain the most handsome. All right, now, for those of you who aren't familiar with what we do on this side of town, I'm going to give you a bit of a heads up, okay? What we do on this side of town is we hold our so-called friends on the right accountable, especially their leader, accountable for their dirty, disgusting, filthy deeds as well as their crimes, all right? And there's plenty of that going on, all right? And so, along those lines, I am going to give each and every single Trump supporter, MAGA-possessed demon, the opportunity of a lifetime. All right. This is your chance to exit my live exit stage left and go on about your day. All right. That goes for you too, Stacey and Janae, because I know you're in my lives, but you're in here under your backup accounts, which we need to get into and talk about. All right. But listen, if you stay here and you subject yourself to this truth, thank you, Z-Pac. If you stay in my live, and you subject yourself to this overwhelming amount of truth mixed with handsomeness, that is completely on you. And you need to enjoy it. And you need to let it sit on your heads. Because I realized yesterday after that conversation, Zeus is winning, right? So, if you don't like the truth, right? If you're one of these people who believes that the election was stolen by President Biden, if you think that Nancy Pelosi was responsible for the attack on the Capitol on January 6th, you're one of those geniuses, right? Or further, you think President Biden is guilty of crimes, and you think Hillary Clinton, she's guilty of crimes. So if you're one of those individuals, just leave this live right now because we're about to turn the temperature up, all right? You don't want to hear none of this truth, but guess what? You don't gotta take my word for it. Listen to your leader.
If you're not happy here, then you can leave. Right. As far as I'm concerned, if you hate our country, if you're not happy here, you can leave. If you're not happy in the U.S., if you're complaining all the time, very simply, you can leave. You can leave right now. Come back if you want. Don't come back. It's okay too. But if you're not happy, you can leave.
All right. If you are sitting at home being radicalized by Donald Trump and the Russian propaganda machine that is running rampant currently through the GOP party, pack your bags and leave the United States of America immediately, because we don't need you here. And that goes for you, Stacey and Janae, because I was very, very, very concerned after that Closet of Truth conversation that we had. And one thing that Janae said to me yesterday that I couldn't, you know, it kept me up at night. It kept Zeus up at night. How many of you have heard Janae say, don't poke the bear, All right. And I got to do this to drive home this point. And if you didn't hear her say it, she always says it. And it's for some reason, you know, I'm an artist, right? And so sometimes when these lines jump out at me, they just stick in my head. So I say, okay, let's get into this. Hold
not
on.
Not necessarily you, maybe all your people. No, I do. Mm-hmm.
Can you not do that?
Hold on. You poke the bear. You poke the bear, you're going to get the bear.
Oh.
But I'll tell you right now.
Okay, so, right. So that's her saying you poke the bear.
Hold on, you poke the bear, you poke the bear, you're going to get the bear.
Okay, so but I just wanted to make sure I heard it right. So you poke the bear, you're going to get the bear. That's what she said to Zeus. And I said, really, really, really? All right, so along those lines, I want to make sure we all understand why I'm bringing this up. So poke the bear... this was a term used during the Soviet era, all right? And this is when folks love talking about poking the, quote, Russian bear. So I did this, if you can go look this up. So now my mind is realizing that yesterday, what I sat through with Stacey and Janae was an exercise by what I suspect could be Russian operatives. And I said, you know what? I'm starting to think that these folks are Russian operatives, especially Janae, because she made that statement and she told on herself that means you got ties to Russia. Then you got all these accounts you're creating on TikTok, all right? And she's using all of it to generate propaganda in her, you know, she said her family or her brother is working for some sort of three-letter agencies, and she didn't say what those three-letter agencies were. So I want you all to be on alert that Janae and Stacey, they could be Russian operatives. Yeah. And, yeah, she blew her cover, and the jig is up, Stacey and Janae. As far as I'm concerned, you're not just MAGA-possessed demons, but you're now, from what I understand, and, you know, you could prove me wrong, you're more than welcome to reach out to me and come in the box, but if you come in my box again, you're going to have to turn on the camera this time. I want to make sure I'm not talking to Vladimir Putin's staff. All right. And the only way I can verify that is if you turn on your cameras and come clean with the American people. All right. And so I decided, you know what? Let's run with this poke the bear theme, because throughout that conversation, I think Janae believes that she's the bear. I think Stacey believes that her and Donald Trump, they're the bear and that they've roared and woken up the American people. But I got a little story for them. So Stacey and Janae, and I'm not saying their last name. So when I say Stacey and Janae, I'm just referring to some general people named Stacey and Janae. It's not the Stacey's and Janae's out there that think that I'm talking. This is a completely different Stacey or Janae. Okay. So, and I'm going to label the Stacey. These are Stacey and Janae demons, MAGA demons. All right. All right. So listen up, you two. All right. And everyone else, cause I got a story for you. You know, I got to come a little prepared. All right. So this is called Donald Trump and the MAGA have poked the bear. All right. Once upon a time, in a land called the United States of America, there was a charismatic orange looking clown and a controversial leader named Donald Trump. He had a large following of dedicated supporters known as the MAGA, Make America Great Demons. All right. Trump's presidency was marked by strong opinions, divisive policies, and a penchant for stirring up controversy. You know, one of them, they go by the name Stir the Pot. I think that's how Snuggles used to go, Stir the Pot. All right. One day, fueled by their unwavering loyalty to Donald Trump and his MAGA demons, they decided to embark upon a mission to poke the bear. The bear in this context represented the established political order and the norms and institutions that had long governed the United States of America. With their fervor and passion, Trump and the MAGA demons, they set out to challenge the status quo. They criticized the media, calling it biased, and spread what they believed to be false narratives. They criticized Zeus. They came into my life and they criticized me. They told me my rhetoric was hateful, even though it's truthful. They called it hateful. This is what they did when they decided to go on this dark and dangerous path. They questioned the integrity of the electoral system, raising concerns about widespread voter fraud despite the lack of substantial evidence. They pushed for policies that prioritized America's interests first, often at the expense of international cooperation. As they poked the bear, tensions began to rise. The political landscape became increasingly polarized, with Trump's opponents growing more vocal and fervent in their opposition. The media, feeling attacked, doubled down on their investigations and scrutiny of Trump and his administration, as well as the MAGA demons. All right? You've poked the bear, Donald Trump, and you MAGA demons. Y'all poked it very well. All right? The bear, and when I say bear in this case, Stacy and Janae, the bear representing the American people grew restless. The country seemed to be on the brink of a deep chasm, with division widening every day. Friendships and families were strained as political ideologies clashed. Trust in institutions began to diminish, and the nation became increasingly fractured. While the bear may have been initially docile, you know, sleeping and resting, it began to wake up from its slumber. Are you hearing me, Stacy and Janae? You've woken your, you two have single-handedly woken the bear. People from all walks of life, tired of the constant turmoil and division, they yearned for unity and stability. They sought leaders like President Biden and Kamala Harris, plus a whole bunch of other Democrats, who could bridge the gaps and begin to restore the trust and focus on the common good rather than the personal agendas and the personal attacks that you two, as well as your friends, love to focus on. So in the next election cycle, get this. This is the scariest part of the story. The bear roared back to life. It rejected the chaos and controversy that had consumed the nation. Instead, it embraced leaders who valued empathy, compassion, and a commitment to healing the wounds of the past. Over time, America learned from its experience of poking the bear. It recognized the importance of respectful dialogue, strength in diversity, and the need for compromise. The bear, once provoked, had taught the nation a valuable lesson about the consequences of reckless actions, lies, misinformation, racism, bigotry, and all kinds of nasty, evil things that Donald Trump and his MAGA demons brought. And it taught them the importance of unity. And so, the story of Donald Trump and the MAGA demons reminds America of the delicate balance between stirring change and preserving harmony. It serves as a reminder that even the mightiest bear can be awakened, and it is in the nation's best interest to tread carefully in its pursuit of democracy. All right? That's the story about poking the bear, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you enjoyed it. I really do hope you all enjoyed that story, all right? And I crafted that specifically for our good friends, Stacy and Janae, all right? So you may have given me the idea about what poking the bear was, but I've taken it from you. So now poking the bear belongs to us. All right. All right, and now we got to, first of all, well, I did enjoy the story. Join me, ladies and gentlemen, in giving Donald Trump and his MAGA demons, including Stacey and Janae, the first round of booze and shame, because they have poked the bear. In this, especially in this kingdom we got going on, oh yeah, y'all poked the bear, a lot of bears actually. So now that we're at this point, you can't, you know, the cat's out of the bag, so to speak. You can't put the cat back in the bag; it's out. So join me in giving Stacey and Janae, who I'm not worried about talking about because, as far as I'm concerned, they said that they've blocked me and they'll never come back. So join me in giving them a round of booze and shame. All right. Now, I hope I don't have to mention them again, all right? But I just wanted to make sure I responded to that element of what I recalled them saying, all right? Now, let's get on, ladies and gentlemen, with today's headlines, and then we're going to get to the boxes, all right? This is some bear poking business, all right? Because, you know, many of you, you know, California is what? Our motto, so to speak. Let's see. Okay. You know, on our flag, we got the bear on our flag, right? So, yeah, this is some more, I guess, poking the bear business, all right? Brought some sad news for you, Trump supporters. Some more bad news for you. Are you ready to hear it? The California bar finds John Eastman culpable for misconduct. If you are a person out here, wait a minute, hold on. I see some dissension in the comments. You didn't like my story about poking the bear? You didn't like my story?
If you're not happy here, then you can leave. As far as I'm concerned, if you hate our country, if you're not happy here, you can leave. If you're not happy in the U.S., if you're complaining all the time, very simply, you can leave. You can leave right now. Come back if you want. Don't come back. It's okay too. But if you're not happy, you can leave.
What I'm bringing is 110% truth. What the panelist brings is 110% truth. All right? If you don't like what we're talking about, Tiny Tim and Double D, so what? So what? We sat here for 4 years and dealt with this orange clown and your behinds in the country, the world. And you get up in my life and have the audacity to start acting like you're triggered. Have you lost your ever-loving minds? And I don't care if I've ruined your breakfast. That's what I intended to do when I woke up. When I woke up this morning, I said, I'm about to ruin 1,000 Trump supporters' breakfast. Spit it out. Throw it away. You don't even deserve to have breakfast. As far as I'm concerned, you're all traitors. You needed to be treated like war criminals. All right? All you do is ride around and spread hate. Evil, misogyny, racism. And then you get on TikTok and somehow find a victim corner. They go and look for a corner called victim corner. And all the MAGA demons, they retreat to a victim corner and somehow go, oh, I'm the victim of what Zeus says. I'm the victim, as if the wave or the wake of destruction that they left on their way to being the victims, we all can't see. For Christ's sakes, you knuckleheads tried to overthrow our government. And then after you did it, you sat back and tried to blame Nancy Pelosi? Have you lost your minds? Ray Epps? The DOJ? If you can wipe your behind on your own, then that means you got enough common sense to think for yourself. And as far as I'm concerned, I'm holding each and every one of you Trump supporters accountable for the same stuff I'm holding Donald Trump accountable. Any of you affiliated with him, the same amount of heat he's catching, you're gonna catch. And And that's according to scripture now that I think about it, right? You know, Jesus has a part in there about the student and the teacher, right? If the teacher's catching the heat, you know the students is going to catch this heat. So if you don't want none of this heat that Zeus and his panelists are bringing, MAGA, denounce Donald Trump today, and I do mean it. I'm willing to hear from you only if you come in the box and apologize, all right? Because, listen, the truth is coming, all right? The California State Bar has found pro-Trump attorney John Eastman culpable of ethics violations and misconduct in his plot to help former President Donald Trump overturn the 2020 presidential election. This is what accountability looks like, tastes like, and smells like. You know, Double D asks me, how does it taste? Double D, it tastes real great. All right. The next phase is determining the penalties for Eastman, which could range from a suspension to permanent revocation of his law license. Eastman, a far-right former law professor, was the author of an infamous memo laying out a six-step plan to throw out electoral votes for then president-elect Joe Biden and kick the election to Trump, even while he purportedly privately admitted the plan was against the law. So, MAGA, let me break this down to you in dummy terms. John Eastman, he was a lawyer, and he also supported Donald Trump. And he decided to throw away his profession for Donald Trump in order to try to help Trump stay in office, even though Trump knew he had lost. Even though everyone knew he lost, this lawyer decided, to hell with my career. I'll do whatever it takes to keep Donald Trump in office. And he did just that. He lied to you, and he committed fraud. And he got caught. And now that he's been caught, he's got to pay for what he did, which means he's going to lose his law license, perhaps, and more. You already know he's a co-defendant in a RICO case out there in Fulton County with our good friend Fonnie Willis. So, in other words, Trump supporters, the election wasn't stolen. President Biden really beat Donald Trump. So, ladies and gentlemen, join me in giving John Eastman the first round of boos and shame for allowing himself to be played by Donald Trump and the MAGA demon and throwing away his law career and getting himself wrapped up in a nasty RICO case. Let's give John Eastman a round of boos and shame. Okay, all right.
If you're not happy here, then you can leave.
There you go. I keep saying, yeah, you know, and I thought it was funny when Stacey and Janae, they were saying, you keep saying, if you're not happy here, you can leave. And I want Stacey and Janae to know that's Donald Trump's voice. When I hit that button, that's Donald Trump's voice. That's not Zeus's voice. So if you don't like what Donald Trump is saying, that's your problem. All right. And I'm going to make sure you know what Donald Trump is saying, because you said something that was very disturbing. You said you vote for Donald Trump, but you don't know what he says. How do you do that? How does a person vote for somebody but has no clue who this person is or what they're saying? Because I'm so busy at work. I'm so busy working, Zeus, that I don't pay attention to what he says, but you know everything President Biden says, and you don't vote for him. So you listen to Biden, you don't vote for him, you don't listen to Trump, and you vote for him. That's that MAGA logic that I'm talking about. Only a MAGA demon could make somebody think that actually makes sense. You definitely, these folks, ladies and gentlemen, they definitely ain't got shoestrings. They got to use button-up shoes, all right? Because that stuff don't make sense to Zeus. It really doesn't, right? All right, let's move on to our next topic, all right? All right, listen. They don't like me because I tell the truth. Well, I'd rather tell the truth and be realer than you than to be in a jail cell with Donald Trump and his supporters trying to fight. Like that guy Jacob who took that street fighter stance. You know, I'm going to fight for Donald Trump. Guess where his behind is at right now? In a jail cell? In a jail cell? In a prison? Fighting for Donald Trump. Protect your back, all right? Protect your backside, all right? Because you got to be real strong in prison, right? Oh, Snuggles uses Velcro shoes. Woo! I tell you, you know, Snuggles, I'm not surprised you live with your mom, with your grandma in the basement, and you're wearing Velcro shoes. Listen, MAGA women, y'all got to do better when it comes to choosing men. If you go on a date and you pick this guy up, imagine picking Snuggles up at his grandma's house. All right, you actually had to catch a lift over there on the Uber, and you think you're gonna get him to take you out in town. You get there, who's home with you, Snuggles? Oh, that's Snuggles. Where you go? You know, that's his grandma, and then he walks out of the house with those Velcro shoes. Oh my God! You can't make this stuff up, folks. You can't make this stuff up. So let's talk about this. Letitia James, she says, we will not be bullied, all right? And she vows to force Donald Trump to do something he's not known to do. Tell the truth. New York attorney Letitia James vowed yesterday to squeeze. And I want you to think about when she said squeeze, think about that orange juice. You know, you have to squeeze that orange and get that juice. She's going to squeeze the truth out of the former president, Donald Trump, when he takes the stand in his New York City fraud trial. Quote, while I am sure he will try to hide his wrongdoings behind taunts, threats, and name calling, she said, quote, we will not be bullied out of uncovering the truth. All right. So, with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, let's go ahead and give Letitia James a round of applause for making orange juice out of an orange clown. Right? And we're going to give Donald Trump another round of booze and shame because it shouldn't have came to this, Donald Trump. If you would have just been an honest businessman from the beginning, you and your supporters wouldn't be in this nasty situation where you're going to where first you're going to go broke and then you're going to go to prison. So let's give Donald Trump his booze and shame.
If you're not happy here, then you can leave.
All right. All right. Oh, wait a second. Someone said I'm the only black man. What do you say? You're the only black man who doesn't support Trump. See, what we got right here is a Russian bot. We got a Russian bot in here named. Okay. Now, first of all, Mr. 248 followers, Kurt LeBar, Frost, whatever your name is. You're wrong. There's a lot of black folks that don't support Donald Trump, Kurt. So I think what this is really about is, you're surprised that you ran into such a handsome black guy like myself who doesn't support Donald Trump, who proudly supports President Biden, right? Because I understand democracy is on the line and Donald Trump is a threat to that, all right? So, Kurt, listen up, Kurt. Pull over, Kurt, pull over right now. Let me see. Kurt, you definitely just got your McDonald's, right? And you're about to eat that egg McMuffin sandwich with a hash brown. You got a little apple pie, Kirk. And you're feeling great, Kirk. All right, Kirk. Well, I got some terrible news for you, Kirk. All right. Donald Trump is going to prison. All right. And guess what, Kirk? You're on your way too. Yeah, because see, we know where you were on January 6th, Kurt. You were there. I can tell you were there, all right? I mean, look at this. And when Jack Smith gets a hold of Donald Trump is going to say, you know, Jack Smith, that guy named Kurt with 240 followers on TikTok, you need to go look at him because he's the one that gave me these ideas, Kurt, right? Kurt, I'm so sorry to tell you this. And also, I got some more worse news. Oh, President Biden is going to get a second term. Oh, yeah. How does that feel, Kurt? I know. It's hard to imagine. All right. And you know, there's also more news coming out. Donald Trump's children, they also might end up getting indicted and going to prison as well. Kurt, how does that make you feel? Knowing that this is really going to happen. Oh my gosh, I know Kurt and pulled that car over. He's over there at that Flying J gas station. You know, when you're on the highway, there's these gas stations called the Flying J, right? Kurt's at that, he just pulled over. He's in the parking lot. Ah, I hate Zeus right now. That's all right, Kurt. That's all right. You'll get used to it, all right? We're going to get that second term out of President Biden, and we're going to get Donald Trump into some handcuffs and in prison real soon. As a matter of fact, he's going to be in prison probably by the end of this year, Kirk. I'm not lying, all right? Kurt, listen, I got some more bad news for you, Kurt. Hold on. All right. Let's see. All right. Oh, my God. Kurt, can you believe all of this is happening to your leader? First, we're going to get Donald Trump's children, and then we're going to get Donald Trump. All right? Because you know what this is, Kurt? The Trump crime family. This is the Trump crime family on full display. And, Kurt, this wouldn't have happened if you didn't poke the bear. But you, Kurt, single-handedly poked the bear. And now you're catching all this heat. Yeah. Imagine that, Kurt. This might be your, I guess that could be Janae's backup account, now that I think about it. That could be Janae on one of her backup accounts. Janae, Kurt, Stacy, whoever you are, cut it out. All right, court denies Ivanka Trump's bid to pause her testimony after she claimed undue hardship if made to appear during the school week. Yes, ladies and gentlemen. So listen, a higher court yesterday denied Ivanka Trump's request to postpone her upcoming testimony in her father's civil fraud trial shortly after she claimed she suffered, quote, undue hardship if forced to appear during a school week. You know, why not just comply, Ivanka? Why? MAGA, y'all are so big on law and order. If Donald Trump is innocent, if he's innocent like you say he is, and this is just all a witch hunt, why not just trust the process? For her to inject her children as an excuse, very, very disgusting, very poor. That's terrible. Don't use your children, Ivanka. If daddy didn't commit any fraud, then you have nothing to fear. Nothing. And I believe, Ivanka, honestly, you just might be the one that could save your father from all of this, because I don't think you would go in there and lie, right? Ms. Trump, who resides in Florida with her three minor children, will suffer a hardship if a stay is denied and she is required to testify at a trial in New York in the middle of a school week, in a case she has already been dismissed from before her appeal is heard, her attorney argued. All right. With the appeal, Trump sought to block New York Judge Arthur Nguyen's previous order for her to testify until an appeal court could be heard by the New York Appellate Court. The appeal also asked the court to pause the entire fraud trial against the former president, two of his adult sons, and his company until the appeal could be heard. The motion for a stay was, quote, swiftly denied in a filing Thursday night. That's yesterday night. So, ladies and gentlemen, join me in giving Donald Trump and Ivanka a round of booze and shame, because they thought that they could get away with it only to get caught. You know, like those Scooby-Doo cartoons. Let's give them their booze and shame. That's what happens when you break the law. You got to do the time. And we all have to play by these rules. Everybody out there should be law-abiding citizens. All of you out there, you know, we should be agents of light, not darkness, all right? I got to say that because some people say my lives are full of hate. No, this is a life full of love. And part of the things you do when you love things and you love someone is you gotta tell the truth and help people be accountable, all right? And so I'm going to get to my last topic, all right? And then we're going to open up these boxes and we're going to have some real conversations with real people out there, right? Because as much as this show is about me, it is also about all of... Oh, no, actually, no. There's one more topic I need to cover, and then we can have our conversation, all right? All right. So I just want to, let me see if I can get this going. All right, hold on. I just want to make sure I get this clear and understood. All right, here we go. All right, so this is definitely a story worth mentioning. All right. Excuse me. Nancy Mace learns the lessons of Lauren Boebert and Marjorie Taylor Greene. All right. And the lesson is MAGA is not for ladies. And I keep trying to tell you Trump supporter women this. It's been a challenging few months for the ladies of MAGA in the House of Representatives, even before she was caught on video getting handsy with a date in public in September. Lauren Boebert of Colorado faced tough re-election prospects, having nearly lost her once deep red district in November of 2022. Now she is facing a cringeworthy headline like, quote, outraged and embattled, Lauren Boebert heads back to Colorado with a revamped campaign strategy. Even in the beat sweetener, the Associated Press reporter can't quite make, quote, vaping and groping with a date during a musical production of Beetlejuice sound like a mere embarrassing moment instead of a full blown faceplant, right? We all saw what Lauren Boebert did. It was disgusting. All right. And let's talk about Marjorie Taylor Greene, or as some like to say, Marjorie Traitor Greene, was once perceived as the far right power behind the throne of Representative Kevin McCarthy, a Republican from California. She lost some MAGA cred this year when she was ousted from the ultra-right Freedom Caucus. Then McCarthy lost his job as Speaker, leaving Greene cut off from both the mainstream GOP and the increasingly powerful radical right. Now Greene spends an inordinate amount of her time in incoherent Twitter beefs with Republican colleagues, right? Oh my gosh. All right. And while Representative Nancy Mace, all right, of South Carolina has succeeded at her goal of being on TV all the time, she's really only defined herself as an empty-headed attention addict. She never could coherently explain why she joined 8 Republicans to oust Kevin McCarthy, even as she grabbed at every microphone to share her nonsense. Her stunt of marching through Congress in a skin-tight Scarlet A t-shirt only reinforced the narrative that her only goal was to get on camera. Now, her own staff has leaked internal documents, all right, that expose her as a, quote, politician obsessed with her public image and fixated on winning herself as much exposure as possible. It all seemed so promising for these 3 women when they first came into Congress in January of 2021. Just combine the, quote, who me, innocent, sexy act of the pageant queen with the belligerent of the nastiest troll on Twitter, and voila, instant MAGA stardom, activating the lizard brain bigotries of the GOP base, works even better in conjunction with titillating their gonads, something Rupert Murdoch and Roger Ailes figured out a long time ago when they put a leg cam on Fox News so male viewers could go all googly-eyed over their female anchors in these so-called miniskirts, all right? But this, ladies and gentlemen, is not working for these 3 MAGA ladies, all right? And so with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, join me in giving Nancy Mace, Lauren Boebert, and Marjorie Taylor Greene a round of booze and shame, because they're losing their stardom and they're losing whatever power they had because they're starting to realize MAGA, unfortunately, ladies, isn't for you. It's only for the deranged men, all right? So let's give Lauren Boebert, Marjorie Traitor Greene, and Nancy Mace their daily dose of booze and shame. Can't make this stuff up. Congratulations, ladies. You've played yourself. All right? You really have played yourself, ladies. And don't come crawling to Zeus when it's all said and done. I don't want to talk to you. You didn't listen to me when I was giving you the opportunity. All right? Now, my last and final topic, ladies and gentlemen. You know exactly what this is about. You all know one of my favorite things to do is to talk about the January 6th traitors who got caught on January 6th. And make sure you are all up to date on some of the things that are going on with these traitors. All right? And a lot of you, you know, I gotta say it before I get into it. You might think that I'm being mean when I do this, but I'm not. I'm actually being nice. I used to be a lot nicer about this, but I can't be nice anymore because the gloves are off.
Everyone knows he's... And I wouldn't have said this 3 weeks ago.
I wouldn't
have said it. I was actually very kind to him. I was very kind to him, but now we can't be kind anymore because the gloves are off. The jar has been opened.
Yes! The gloves are off and the jar is open. The bear has been poked, MAGA. All right? And so I'm going to keep bringing these stories to the forefront so that the American people are fully aware of what happens when you poke the proverbial bear. All right? A Tennessee man who was seen crowd surfing over the mob of Donald Trump supporters in an apparent attempt to fight with police at the Capitol on January 6th appeared ready to end it all to keep the former president in office. All right, let's look at this MAGA demon. All right, there he is. All right. Michael Tyler Roberts. 34 years dumb. 34 years dumb. Was seen climbing on the heads and shoulders of pro-Trump rioters gathered at the tunnel at the Capitol's Lower West Terrace that day, according to federal prosecutors. What is this? Donkey Kong? What game is this? Shortly before 4 p.m., surveillance video footage shows Roberts moving swiftly over the top of other rioters to get closer to the police line at the tunnel. This is what he did. From his position on top of the other rioters and the officers defending the Capitol, Roberts is visibly grappling with those officers and grabbing hold of their hands and arms. He's attacking law enforcement. The probable cause affidavit says, during the melee, Roberts' hat was discarded. Look at him. Look at him. Look at him going into the tunnel. Look at the guy out to the back. Got his, you know, he got his rear end bent over. He's bent over for Donald Trump, right? He's bent over for Donald Trump. Nasty, nasty, nasty. According to the criminal complaint, Roberts had purchased a set of brass knuckles for this specific purpose of fighting at the Capitol on January 6th, when Congress was tasked with certifying President Joe Biden's win in the 2020 presidential election. He also told his companion, Ronald McAbee, who has also been charged with Capitol riot offenses, that he planned on wearing MAGA gear. MAGA gear. Shorthand for the pro-Trump slogan, Make America Great Again. And he is indeed seen in pictures wearing a red sweatshirt emblazoned with MAGA in white letters. This is a MAGA demon on full display, ladies and gentlemen. This is the MAGA demon on full display. and it was caught by the DOJ, right? Like other accused of, like other accused January 6 rioters, Roberts appeared to think his Capitol quest would be a one-way trip. Quote, "Man, this isn't just a fight for Donald Trump," he said in an interview on the Capitol grounds on the day of the attack. "This is a fight of good versus evil, right versus wrong. I love my country. I had to tell my son before I left home, listen, son, I'm doing this for you. Daddy may not come home, but that's okay. I'll stand in the gap so he doesn't have to. So your kids don't have to. I'll take whatever comes." This is what a grown man, 34 years old, dumb, said to his son. Stacy, Janae, what about protecting the children? What do you got to say about this? What kind of parent does this? The complaint was filed on October 23rd. He is charged with obstruction of law enforcement during a civil disorder, a felony punishable by up to 5 years in prison, and 3 disorderly conduct and trespassing misdemeanors, according to court documents. Roberts was arrested this past Wednesday. So, ladies and gentlemen, we gotta, first of all, let's give Robert his a round of booze and shame. This is why we call domestic terrorists. Roberts, you need to enjoy being in prison with your other friend Jacob and all these other ones, Enrique, all of y'all. Be in prison for Donald Trump. Enjoy. You know, look at this. I don't know what move this is on Street Fighter, but he has a pole, his friends behind him. It looks real nasty, all right? And you did it all for Donald Trump, and you actually had the audacity to say this to your son. "Daddy may not come home because I'm throwing my life away for Donald Trump," which you did. So, ladies and gentlemen, let's send this Michael Tyler Roberts, 34 years dumb. Let's send him off the old-fashioned way. I let it play a little longer than I normally do because there's a child, he has a son, and his son had to watch him do such a thing, be a traitor to this nation. Look at what you've done, MAGA. Look at what you've done. We didn't poke this bear, you did. And now the bear is awake. And it's getting real uncomfortable, isn't it? It's getting real uncomfortable in the United States for you. And that's exactly what happens when you poke the bear. So don't come and complaining to Zeus and saying Zeus is putting out hateful rhetoric. No, you MAGA-possessed demons seriously have poked the bear. And when the bear's up, He's not coming to be friendly with you. You disturbed his sleep, her sleep. You disturbed some very valuable rest that the bear was really enjoying. Worked real hard to get into a situation where it could hibernate. You know, if you follow what bears do, they eat up and then they go lay their behinds down. And your Humpty Dumpty, Trumpty Dumpty behinds, MAGA possessed, you wandered into the bear's cave. And you poked the bear, now the bear's up. Oh, my God. All right, ladies and gentlemen. That concludes the morning show.
All right, it's time to open up these boxes and hear from those of you brave enough to get in the box and tell the truth. Listen, and I don't want nobody in here claiming that to be victims. You got an ample warning. I've given you all the same warning that I give all of you.
If you're not happy here, then you can leave.
You can't be mad at anything that I've said or any of the panelists said because you chose to sit in this live and listen to this special broadcast. I didn't come to your house, grab your phone, and say, listen to Zeus, listen to his live. I didn't do that. You did that to yourself. And I know why you did it, because you know God's working on your behinds. You've been living in darkness. You've been living in sin. You're probably working for Vladimir Putin. And the truth hits you like a ton of bricks. It hit you like a ton of bricks. Am I getting them straight facts? Am I getting them? It hit you like a ton of bricks. Woke your game up. You ain't ever had nobody wake your game up like this. But it's woke. Like that bear. And we coming. And I know I'm coming for you.
All right. All right. Y'all gonna get me into trouble. Y'all gonna get Zeus into trouble. Y'all really.
All right. All right. Superwoman, good morning. How are you?
Hey, good morning, Zeus. What's up, chat?
Hey, it's a pleasure to have you here. All right.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
All right.
Now, I'm laughing so hard, man, because I have heard really respectable people, you know, compliment you. And this is my first time on your panel. But my goodness, what genius work. I'm talking about very clear, classic. I'm talking about real commitment, and it Thank just you. Brings common sense, first of all. Second of all,
wow.
You know, it just says to me that what we see is very real, and yeah. that we do have to keep putting in this damn work, because yeah. these motherfuckers are...
Oh, wait, now we got to keep it clean.
I saw that the cluckers.
Mm-hmm. Fair enough. We can live with that.
Are just completely out of their minds. Mm-hmm. And like you said, you know, the only thing, you know, that really makes sense, because it's not of this world, this type of delusion, this type of commitment to this type of person, right, mm-hmm. can only come from an extremely dark place. Demonic is a great explanation
yep.
In description. And I'm just like, I'm not, you know, I'm not getting ready to play, man. I'm trying to use TikTok friendly words, but the fire is real. The anger is real. The disappointment is there. Mm. And at some point, man, we have to say in the most transparent way, wake the, you know what, up.
Bingo.
You know, we see you. We know who you are. We are aware. We are not going to ever be sold out that this is a quality person to be the president of the United States, first of all. Second of all, he is one of the most crooked, intentionally dishonest people I think I've ever witnessed. And it is not our fault. And I think that's my last point, is that you said that.
Yeah.
This is... Superwoman didn't do this to you, right? Mm-hmm. Zeus didn't do this to you. Mm-hmm. Straight Facts didn't do this to you. Union Gang did not do this to you. You guys come for us like we are, you know, like we have, you know, photos of us climbing up the Capitol and, you know, wiping poop everywhere. And like, we're the ones who are violent and hostile and rioting right. and destroying things and shit and stuff. But it's not us. Like I said, that fire is there, you know, educational purpose is only TikTok, but my goal is to just say this. Keep going. I got your crown, King. I see you working. I see you putting in that genuine effort. I'm committed because of people like you. You guys inspire the crap out of me to keep going as well. These are not Republicans. We have heard real Republicans only for this next election jump camp. Like, no, I cannot have these people representing a real political party, right? In the name of being us, no, absolutely not. This is not us.
Right.
And I respect that. I respect that. We don't have to agree on everything.
No.
But what we do have to come to terms with is that, and I'll land with this, is that this country is growing and it is progressive and it's starting to heal. There is a healing process that we are in.
Tell them.
If we are not fighting for that healing process, we can lose it. And we can be set so freaking far backwards. And it will be our responsibility then. Then it will fall on us if we don't fight with everything that we have. So let's keep fighting for the healing process to be continued to expand. Let's keep making sure we are screaming how important it is to vote blue in 2024.
Amen.
Thank you so much, Zeus, for having me. I appreciate it so very much. I love you, chat. I can't wait to hang out with you guys tonight over in Ewing Gang headquarters.
Amen.
Superwoman is everywhere all the time, putting in work, making a difference. I am her.
You are.
She is me. Power to the people.
Bingo. No lies detected. All right, Superwoman. Listen, you're going to get very far with that attitude in this kingdom. You are. Trust me. All right. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give the beautiful Superwoman a round of applause. No lies detected. All right. It's like my grandmother says, tell the truth and shame the devil. All right. See, MAGA, I still see some dissension in the comment section. I don't know why these Trump supporters are in the live complaining about all of this truth.
If you're not happy here, then you can leave. As far as I'm concerned, if you hate our country, if you're not happy here, you can leave.
Yeah, leave. Go to Russia, be with your Lord and Savior, Vladimir Putin. All right. Let's go. All right. Good morning, Bamba. I haven't heard from you.
Oh, wow. I didn't know you pulled me up.
Well, I haven't heard from you quite a while.
Yeah, I took yesterday off.
Oh, is everything
okay? To read the news, and I was late today because, you know, there's stuff coming out, and you have to go double check and check things out. So.
As you should.
Yeah, so there's been some activity in the skies, people, and don't panic. It's a practice, right?
Mm.
We're practicing. We are at some heated times, and Biden is going to Maine to address the people, so he's not up in the sky, you know, flying around.
Oh, okay.
And, there are going to be travel bans in Europe, so if you have family who's in Europe or the Middle
wow.
East.
Really?
Poland's closing their borders.
And this is in response to the conflict with Israel?
Yeah, and, you know, I keep telling everybody Wagner is part of Hamas.
Right.
It just came out, and Wagner is sending air defense systems to Hezbollah.
Oh.
Yeah, Hezbollah has been fighting over at the Lebanese West Bank border. So.
Wow.
I think that's their way of saying that they've been there all along, and they might find some Russians in those trenches. I mean, in those tunnels. Yeah.
Mm.
So,
wow.
Yeah.
Interesting. Very, very interesting.
So I wanted, you know, Superwoman, she's wonderful, and we have to fight for what she outlined. You know, we're going to be attacked from all sides.
Outside and inside.
Right. Coming from the outside, they're going to pull the scabs off our insides.
Mm.
So we've got to face the fact that we've been played from on the outside, right? And we went along with them.
Yeah.
But now more than ever, we have to really, really consider our own faults and how we can, you know, make it better.
Yeah.
Stop blaming everybody. I mean,
bingo.
Blaming other people, you have to be accountable and for your actions.
Bingo.
You have to hold your own accountable. I mean, if you don't hold your kids accountable, what happens? Right?
You set them up for failure.
Right. And so, you know, we're doing the same thing with our government. We're setting our government up for failure if we're not holding them accountable.
Exactly. And that's what this is all about. As much as it seems like it's personal, this is really about
it isn't. And it's, you know, now Xi is coming, or the Secretary of State is coming from China Thursday.
But Biden is supposed to be meeting with Xi, right?
They're our last-ditch effort, really, at being able to calm this down. Right. Ukraine is at a stalemate. So there's not going to be a big hurrah this winter, their head of military said. Okay. So I don't know. We are in a little precarious, more precarious situation, but most important is what we as Americans do for ourselves and those around us.
Amen. Well, listen up, Bamba. Thank you.
I love you, Zeus.
Love you too. All right, ladies and gentlemen.
Bye, everybody.
Let's give Bamba a round of applause, the beautiful Bamba, ladies and gentlemen, right? No lies detected. I always enjoy when Bamba gives me updates on foreign affairs. All right. Good morning, Dark Cece. How are you doing?
I'm lovely this morning. How is my handsome, humble, and honest?
Thank you. Brandon? I'm doing great. I slept like a baby last night. You did too? All right.
Oh, well, yes, yeah. I did. Yes. Right, well, you made me sleep like a baby, baby.
Keep it clean.
No, I think you made me sleep like a baby, baby. Yeah,
okay.
I call my friends baby and honey, and you know.
Okay. I'm just making sure. I'm just checking with you, all right?
No. Hey, look, if anything's going to happen like that, it's going to be a private PM, okay? I don't be putting my stuff out here on live.
Okay. Listen, it's your thing. You can do what you want. You can do what you want when you're popping. I get it. All right. You do what you want, Cece. You do what you want. All right.
I want you to know that not only do you have the triple H's, but I'm going to give you some triple L's.
What the heck? What is the triple L's about, Dark Cece?
You bring light. Love.
Oh.
And laughter.
Oh.
To your lives. Okay?
Cece, you're making me blush. You really are.
I want you to blush because you're special. You work hard. I'm going to protect you like I've told you before.
Oh.
I will not have anyone talking down or about you. And if it happens, you know that I will come to you about it.
And I am aware of that.
And I'm not going to take screenshots. You're just going to take my word.
Absolutely.
Because my word is truth. Okay?
Amen.
And I thank you for everything. You're the best. I've been following you for a while now.
You have. You've been rocking with me for a while.
I have. You're my buddy. You're thank my buddy.
You. Listen, Cece. You're going to go very far with an attitude like that. Listen. All right.
You know I love you, right?
I know. I love you as well, all right? And I appreciate all you do to help keep this going, all right? Actually, you got a lot of friends out there that love you as well.
I saw that yesterday. Touched my heart. It really touched mine too.
Yeah. You know, even though it was a tough situation, I did recognize all of the love and support that is going on with this platform. So shout out to all of you as well. That's amazing.
Yes, I was totally impressed and appreciative, you know, of all the good people that are in your lives, because you have a lot of good people in your lives.
Yeah.
And you know, you have the little trolls and the little rats that slide in.
Yeah.
And I get rid of them, you know, I get rid of them. And I hope, you know, I don't get rid of somebody you really like, but.
There are occasions where there's some friendly fire. So, you know, but I think we're doing the best we can, you know,
Do you keep up the good work? And you continue to bring the light, the love, and the laughter to your lives.
Thank you. I'm going to have to note that.
Because those two will not bring you down.
Absolutely not. You're right, Dark Cece.
Okay, honey, I'm not going to take up all your time.
All right. Well, listen up. I appreciate you, Dark Cece. All right.
I hope I see you the weekend.
Oh, you never know. Depends on what's going on in the kingdom. I might decide to go live, but usually I take weekends off, all right?
I don't blame you. Okay, buddy. Have a good one.
All right.
Have a good weekend.
Let's give the beautiful dark CC a round. No lies. No lies detected. All right. Listen, ladies and gentlemen, there are a lot of people here that are committed to the truth. And that's what this is truly about, getting it out there, making sure we save democracy. Good morning, the beautiful Shay. How are you? I'm all right. Just another day in the kingdom tending to these affairs.
That's amazing. Can the MAG explain this?
I'm sorry. Mama didn't do it, Bob. You can do it, baby. I love you so much. Magic. And this is bad news. Bad things are happening. Mom, I'm sorry. Mom, I didn't do it, Pop. You can do it, baby. I love you so much. Magic. And this is bad news. Bad things are happening.
Wow.
This is Mom Runner.
Mom, I'm sorry.
This is your front runner.
Woo!
Seriously.
What's going on in that bedroom?
Scary. Poor Melania. She didn't probably like, brace yourself, Effie. I don't even understand this, you know? Like he was in Houston yesterday, and that was a speech. It was beautiful. Wow. I don't understand how that's your front runner, Republicans. Or are you wanting to be the unity party? You got Marjorie Taylor Greene all upset and, you know, talking about taking down of statues of our founding fathers, but yet she was referencing Robert E. Lee, which from my account, you know, right. I know I'm a history professor, but from what I remember in history, Robert E. Lee was a Confederate general, not a founding father.
Right.
But yet it's okay to burn books and rewrite history in their version, right? And whitewash everything. But, you know. That's
interesting part, right?
It really is. And so MAGA or the Republicans, GOP, whatever, are eating their own. They're constantly fighting. You saw that Ken Buck is leaving Congress.
I heard.
Mitt Romney's not coming back. They're losing their actual conservatives.
Why do you think they're leaving? Is it because the support's just not there anymore, you think?
I think they have support within their constituents because if you notice, MAGA candidates are losing across the board. They're losing. Wow. Especially even in the Deep South in Tennessee, many of the MAGA candidates and stuff have lost. So in general, what people need to understand is that is not popular within the groups on the right. It's just not. They don't want it. So when you lose people like Ken Buck and that are real conservatives and Mike Pence has dropped out of the race. And, you know, when you look at this, you have to understand, and just like Itchy has always called it, you know, Donald Trump will take down the Republican Party. And that is what has happened.
Huh.
They don't even know who they are. They don't know who's driving them. You watch the Speaker of the House. You know, debacle through this year twice. It's a small minority of 8 to 20 of them, right? Called the Freedom Caucus. But it's a very minor amount. And so, you know, I was on a live the other day with a MAGA person and like, we're not going away. There's so many of us. And I'm like, yeah, there's really not actually.
Right.
There's really not a lot of you, right? Republicans are 30%, right? So if you take MAGA, you're probably at 15%. So then you're being
50%
of the voting base.
Right.
So take 15% of 155 million. There's 180 million registered voters, right? 155 million voted in 2020.
Mm-hmm.
So take 15% of that. That's where you are, right? About 17%? Okay, cool. I love that. So I wasn't too far off in my guesstimation. I like that.
Right.
So we need to pay attention to all of that, guys. Listen, they're loud. They're very loud, especially on this app. I get it. So it makes you feel like you're living amongst them and there's millions of them running around. There's not.
There's not. There's not.
They're extremists. They're extremists. And so, and I don't know what the Republican Party is going to do. And the other thing, have y'all noticed that Nikki Haley has popped up to 22%?
Oh, yeah, I did see that.
Yeah.
I think they're preparing her for to be the Republican front runner. That's just my opinion, to be quite honest. But you know,
right. And so Minnesota is voting to take him off the ballot. It's going to the Supreme Court.
Thank you.
Colorado's in there. There's
quite a few. Get him off the ballot, please.
If he gets off the ballot, then that means the RNC has to, they're going to have to make a decision who's their actual front runner.
You hear that, Kurt?
Yeah, they're going to have to do it because he can't win if he's taken off his state ballots. The Electoral College, the math won't math. So they are going to have a come into Jesus meeting and figuring it out. But they're scared of that little minor base because they're radicalized.
As they should.
Yeah, they're radicalized. So it's really sad. But anyway, okay, wanted to leave y'all with that. And let's do better, shall we?
We will.
It's a doozy. It's actually not unconstitutional. See, when you people believe in states' rights, they can take every state controls their own elections. You learning the Constitution would be very important. You talk about abortion rights. Well, that's a state. It's a state's right. Okay. Well, so is this doozy. This is a rights issue. They control their own elections. Okay. So Colorado has a rule in there that if you give comfort and all that to insurrection, aid and comfort, any of that, they can remove you from the ballot. That is their state rules. That's their state law.
Remove, Doozy. Now, Doozy is saying they're going to write them in. What do you say to that, Shay?
Oh, good luck. Yeah. It's not going to help you.
All right.
All right. Thank you so much. Love you guys.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up to the beautiful Shay. No lies detected, Doozy. Happy Friday to you.
Love you, Zeus. Bye.
All right, love you too. Listen up, Doozy. I hate to bust your bubble, but you're going to have to find another candidate to support. And you know, Doozy, I know you're on the other side and you've been rocking with me for a while, so I'll give it to you, all right? I'll give it to you. But I have no reason to lie to you about this. You might want to look for another candidate, all right? Or do this, Doozy. Vote blue and put an end to all the pain and suffering, all right? All right, let's bring up our next panelist. Good morning, the beautiful Takesha. Welcome. How you doing? Happy Friday.
Zoo.
Yes.
It's Takesha.
Takesha.
Yeah, you got to say it like Takesha.
Takesha. Oh.
I came up to say this.
Hey
boo-boo.
Oh.
Hey boo-boo.
Oh.
So that's the only bell you poking when you poking her Yogi. she don't roar no louder than Yogi.
Oh.
Hey boo-boo.
Ooh.
Anyway. Listen. You know. Good. I hate I have a grandbaby yesterday. That's why I couldn't cut up because she was sitting in my face. So I was trying to be the example to Zoe of the type of person I want Zoe to be until it's time to snap. But I was trying to be a good grandmother on yesterday.
I respect that. That's what we're supposed to do.
You know what bothers me?
What's that?
It's when and MAGAites continue to blame Pelosi for calling in the National Guard. I know they can't read. Mm-hmm. You know, I offered hooked on funded classes and they didn't come. They probably didn't know what it meant. But if you just go read the duties of the Speaker of the House, you will see that there is nowhere in the duties in the Speaker of the House to call in the National Guard.
No duty.
That's number one. It's not like when we apply for a job where it says not limited to. There's nowhere in that job description for the Speaker of the House.
Right.
Number two, if Trump thought that it was going to be so bad He didn't have to ask Nancy Pelosi nothing. He said he was the most powerful man in the world in his position. Mm. All he had to do was send them.
Mm.
There's nothing she can block that the president of the United States does. Mm. She is the speaker of the House.
Amen.
The only thing she does is stand in the stead for her party on bills that they're trying to pass.
Get them.
She ain't got control of nothing that you people keep making up. Mm. But if you would take the time to let somebody read it to you, because I'm pretty sure you can't read, and you will find out what her duties are so this man can quit lying to y'all and y'all could quit believing him.
Amen.
It's getting more ridiculous by the months.
It is. It really is.
Y'all just some Buddha fools.
No,
and I'm embarrassed for you. I am so embarrassed for you people that keep falling behind this nutcase. But I understand, you know, that front of that hair swung and hypnotized you. Now you need to go to Louisiana.
Okay.
And find a witch doctor.
Oh.
And let her reverse that spell that came through that hair that day he put that extra mousse in there. And you stood there and watch it wave like Miss America.
Oh.
So you can get rid of this spell that's on you from this pootie dude, man. Leaky cheek has messed y'all up.
Oh, he has.
And I used to feel sorry for you, but I don't.
You don't?
Enough is enough. You know, I said I wasn't gonna send them about the Dizzy Chicks.
Oh.
But the new name is the Dingy Chicks. Because the Dingy Chick came for CeCe after they swear they wanted things to be unified. Came and talked about CeCe. And CeCe too soft for me.
Mm.
I don't know what's wrong with CeCe.
Mm.
But CeCe gonna have to be like a boulder and go back because they're bullies. And as long as a bully think they can bully you, they'll keep bullying you.
Mm.
She got to come back for him, Zeus.
Mm.
Now, like I said, I had a lot I wanted to say, but my grandbaby was looking dead in my face.
I know.
God. And I wanted to say, if you don't get in the house so grandma can say what she got to say, but she wouldn't leave my side. And I said it to myself. The Lord must be sparing.
He is.
He was sparing them. Because I had already did my greatest show on earth.
Guess
he said, look, let me give you bronchitis after that.
Oh,
and
God.
I'm not going to allow you to mess with Yogi and hey, boo-boo again.
So, oh, my Lord.
I'm going to take it as, you know, the Lord was saying.
He was speaking to you, huh?
You've done enough, Kiki. Okay. You've done enough.
All right. So, you're right.
I'm going to go on, Zeus.
All right.
And I want you to have a fantastic day.
I will. And you too. All right.
All right, brother. Takesha. Y'all enjoy y'all weekend.
You too, Takesha. All right.
Takesha.
Have a great rest of your day. All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up to the beautiful Takesha. No lies. No lies detected. Listen, we're still bringing this heavy hammer truth down on you Trump supporters, all right? Because we understand what's at stake, all right? And if you don't like what we're saying in this live, you are more than welcome to pack your bags and leave.
If you're not happy here, then you can leave. Mm. As far as I'm concerned, if you hate our country, if you're not happy here, you can leave.
Amen. That's facts. All right. We're cruising through the guests. Good morning, Miss Voss Diva. How are you?
Good morning, Mr. Handsome Triple H with the H. Yeah. The most important H for me is handsome. But
thank you.
Anyway. Well,
and you know how nutty gets when you say that. But we don't care what nutty thinks.
No, we do not. No, we do not. I said good morning to nutty this morning. So
okay, well, that's good.
Most I took of care time, of my
I wouldn't
duties.
Even give him that. I wouldn't even say good morning to him until he comes correct.
All you right. Say I wouldn't give him that.
Nah, because he's out of order.
Yeah, he is out of order in this kingdom.
When it comes to that.
He's out of order. But, yeah, so I wanted to shout out my queen, Superwoman. I'm so glad that she was able to grace this panel
right.
with the you know, the royalness that she brings and the superpower that she brings. So I want to shout out to my queen. Of course, you know, straight facts. You know what I mean? That's basically, you say partner in crime, but I think we all partners in crime, boss, you know, with this whole bossing up thing about the democracy needing to be saved, and we just really got to put in this work. We really got to penetrate as many people as we can to let them understand. Now, this whole thing about them not wanting to vote for Biden now because of this, you know, Middle East situation, it really teased me off. Yes. Y'all was all with it. Y'all, yeah, vote blue, Joe Biden, all this. You riding with Biden, you thriving with Biden. But the moment that something go on outside of your own home, because we got problems here.
Amen.
We got way too many problems here to, you know, ignore or whatever. Yeah, they got issues. And yes, we are in bed with Israel and, you know, we have to, you know, be their ally or whatever. Okay. But we have a lot of things to straighten out here first. This should be our priority. You know what
Bingo.
I mean? If you know, you got your own home, right? Yeah. You're not going to be worried about what somebody else is doing in their home when your home needs some attention.
Needs the attention.
You know what I mean? That's generally.
That's how it works.
Yeah, it's generally how it works, you know? Yeah. So, I mean, I just don't understand why they want to just flip like that. You know, it was never, to me, you know, loyalty is everything in my life.
Amen.
If you're not loyal to me in any kind of way, like in terms of, you know, just really having my back and I can be comfortable in your presence and, you know, things like that. I mean, I just can't have it any other way.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Well, you know, I think a lot of times people want, they want everything to be perfect, right? And I think that's the mistake a lot of the Democrats tend to make, is they think Biden has to walk and do everything perfect. Not going to happen. No right. leader is perfect.
I mean, nobody is perfect walking on this earth's surface. You know, not one thing, not even an animal, an insect, nothing is perfect.
Nope.
You know,
you're going to do some things that disappoint me. Yeah.
You know what I mean? And so we have to learn to live, but we're not going to be dealing with such criminal imperfections to where we have to, you know, endure all this crime and then he's stealing millions and millions, adding up to billions of dollars.
You know, exactly.
Money from overseas that they don't need, you know, that they shouldn't have.
Tell them,
you know, making deals. You know, because that $2 billion could actually go to our country, right? Yeah. And we can feed the homeless, and we can feed the hungry, and we can, you know, do better for vets, and we can even get us a health care plan in this country. What about that?
Right.
You know what I mean? $2 billion can do a lot for us.
Amen.
You know what I mean?
Tell
but
Ms. Boss D.
Anyway, I heard my bell, Zeus, so, you know, I just want to come up here, show you some love like I always do.
I appreciate you. Everything
have a happy Friday. Happy weekend, y'all.
All right. You too, ladies and gentlemen. Let's give it up to the beautiful Miss Boss Diva. Nobody can take it. Not that hard to tell the truth, all right? It's really not. I mean, everyone that gets into the panel, and they come in the panel and they speak, all of these folks, ladies and gentlemen, I want you to understand, they do their research before they get in the box, and they tell the truth, okay? That's what this is really all about, all right? I don't have to program people. Oh my God, what the heck is going on back there?
Good morning.
I can hear you.
So,
there's a lot of noise. There's a lot of noise.
All right, I'll drop down and come back up. I'll drop down. Right. Go ahead and get somebody else, and I'll come back up after your next guest.
Fair enough. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we'll let Nutty get back to us. Yeah. All right. Let's bring up our next panelist. All right. Mishi. Good morning. How are you doing? Don't worry, everyone. I see you. Good morning, Mishi. How are you? Ooh, face reveal. Good morning. How are you?
I'm pretty good. How are you?
I'm all right. Just another day in the kingdom, as usual.
Let me get some more light here.
Okay. Listen. I mean, I know I'm handsome, but their beauty is. Oh my God! You're taking the attention from Zeus. Oh my God! All right.
Hey, you know what I think is great is that Trump is going to be their nominee, right? Guaranteed. Mm-hmm. Right. There's nothing to change between now and November, and he's going to be found guilty because his co-defendants have been found guilty, and we're going to have to watch them like,
yeah,
to like try to find a replacement. And how, like, again, with the speaker, you know, they,
yeah,
he's out now. You got Johnson, couldn't go to Jordan, and this shows how chaotic they are. So, I love for them. Trump cannot be their nominee, and he is their nominee, but they're gonna have to face a reckoning to either run him as a felon,
right?
Replace him, and I think that's great.
Do you think they'll be able to find someone to replace him if that's the necessary step to take?
Yeah.
You know, you think it's Nikki Haley or is someone else, or maybe DeSantis?
No, I think
it's
Nikki. I think Nikki is polling the best in the Republican Party as someone who can beat Joe Biden.
Oh.
So, I mean, I think actually it's a little scary. I do think Nikki Haley has a real shot. So.
Oh, my, okay. Wow. Wow. So listen, Doozy, you might want to vote for Nikki Haley, Doozy, if I'm hearing this correctly, because Donald Trump, like you said, you believe he's most likely going to get convicted, correct?
I do. Yes. I mean, because, I mean, his co-defendants are pleading guilty.
Mm.
So if they're pleading guilty, then there's enough evidence for them to plead guilty. They're all his lawyers. They were all in it with him. So.
Wow. No lies detected. She's not lying. No.
But here's my question, Zeus.
Talk to me.
What is going to, okay, so Trump, I think his days are numbered. What is going to happen to the MAGA movement? Will they keep with MAGA and just find a new messiah? Will they just pick up like a DeSantis or a like, what are they going to do with the movement? Do they pack up in like a Tupperware container all their shirts and hats? Like, what is going to happen when Trump's days
Mishi, you're scaring them. You're scaring the Trump supporters right now. They're gonna lose their. They're gonna poop their diapers.
They already hate me.
It's fine. MAGA, what's gonna happen?
What's gonna happen? Like, I want to know what they do.
Well, they say he's not going to prison, right? They say he got Secret Service, and they won't let him.
Well, they can say whatever they want. They've been saying a lot for years that's full of shit.
Oh! So,
the storm is coming. The storm's been coming for years. The storm is coming. Today we're supposed to start WW3, according to them.
My gosh. Did we miss the invitation?
Yeah, I have it up on my page. Anyway.
Oh, I got to go see this.
Yeah. So anyway, I really want to know what you guys are going to do. When he is convicted and his days are over, what are you going to do with the hats, the sheets, the t-shirts, the flags, your blankets, your little Trumpy bears? What are you going to do with it all?
Oh, is it, maybe they could sell it? Anyone want to buy some extra, anyone want to buy some Trump paraphernalia out there?
You know, it's going to be like, you know what, we're going to find it like all over like Salvation Army and stuff. Or sadly, we're going to send it and we're going to see like kids overseas with like old Trump shirts.
Oh my God. That is wild. You know, I'm going to be looking for it. I'm going to be looking for discarded Trump gear. All right. After the 2024 election, I'm going to go look for it and see where they decide to discard it. All right. A bonfire.
I want to know who their new messiah is going to be, because without Trump leading, what's going to happen?
Mm. Wait,
it's only, I did look, only 24% of Americans have a favorable view of MAGA.
Wasn't it, I thought it was a lot higher than that at one point. Wasn't it like 30-something percent, perhaps?
Favorable view of MAGA, the movement?
Yeah. I mean, years ago, perhaps. Wasn't it a lot higher?
It's April. This one was April of 2023.
So you're saying the support has declined. There's no way Trump can win again. MAGA? Not if the support's
going down. Well, the view of MAGA itself. Now, Republicans will be Republicans. I know people who are anti-Trump who vote for him because they vote Republican. But the MAGA movement is seen negatively.
Got it.
Does that make sense?
Yes, the movement. Okay. You hear that, MAGA? The movement is not seen so popularly anymore. It's going down the drain. All right. Thank you.
Thanks for having me, Zeus.
All right, no problem, ladies and gentlemen. Let's give it up to the beautiful Mishi. All right, make sure you check out her content. All right, and follow her. All right, you're gonna get truth over there too. Thank you so much. All right.
Have yourself a day as wonderful as you.
All right, thank you. That means a lot. All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's give Mishi a round of applause. No lies. It's not that hard to get in the box. and tell the truth. It's like my grandmother says, tell the truth and shame the devil. You see how, you see what it takes, Stacy and Janae? You were crying and you were saying, Zeus, you're running a, they said, Zeus, I'm running a grifting platform. You should have heard what they said. He's running a grifting platform while they sat there and grifted the heck out of their supporters on my platform. While they sit there and support Donald Trump, who's grifting his way to prison. They had the audacity to try to single me out and say I'm doing something that amounts to what they support when it comes to Donald Trump. Absolutely not, Stacey and Janae. I denounce you. I rebuke you in the name of the Lord. Good morning, Nutty Professor. How are you doing? Oh, my God.
I'm doing well.
Facts. Yes.
Sorry about that. Mm-hmm. So, about a week ago, I think I heard, in one of your monologues, I believe I heard you talking about a cancellation of some sort of train.
The Trump train.
In California?
Bomb. Yes. The speed rail that's going to connect.
Yeah. And didn't you say that was was supposed to commence in Bakersfield?
Yeah.
So, if I'm not mistaken, isn't Bakersfield where Kevin McCarthy resides?
Absolutely.
So, what's interesting is that we know that transportation in the United States really sucks when it especially compared to our European, you know, buddies, because if you get to Europe, you don't
wait. Hold on. Maureen says Nutty is fine in the comments.
Maureen,
right, please continue, Nutty. Please continue, Nutty. I wasn't even
reading the comments to you, so you just brought it to my attention that Maureen is telling the
absolute truth.
I
don't want it to spread like a virus.
Keep spreading, Maureen, because that's the truth. So anyway, if you go to Europe, you can just hop on a train and you can be in other countries within, you know, literally an hour, 2 hours. that high-speed rail,
right?
The high-speed rail is a good thing. So why do we keep cutting our nose off to spite our face? And that wasn't a threat, by the way. That wasn't a threat, because you know I have to quantify my statements now and qualify my statements.
Yeah, you gotta be careful.
Whatever. So anyway, so that's just one of the things that I wanted to bring up. Another thing is that I'm accused of being a woman abuser. I'm accused of sending death threats.
That was said to you by Russian operatives. But
here's what's interesting. Here's what's interesting. They accuse me of that, where they have no proof, but yet the orange orangutan that they support, we have tons of proof that he are these things, because currently, right now, he has a gag order because he's inciting more violence. He incited January 6th. We know he has over 26 allegations of SA. We know he has been found liable for SA. But yet, they're still supporting him. The very people accusing me of such negative and horrible things are supporting a known candidate who has done these things.
They do.
Make it make sense.
They proudly do it, too.
Make it make sense. He is constantly, every time he gets on his little social media, because I will not call it truth, because there ain't no truth about that. Every time he gets on there at 3 o'clock in the morning and posting stuff, he is inciting violence.
Threatening judges, prosecutors, and their family court staff.
But yet, it's funny, we don't hear a doggone thing from them saying, I don't condone that behavior. But yet they want to get up in these boxes, in these TikTok streets, and want to seem holier than thou. The devil is a lie.
Tell them, Nutty.
Yes, I'm calling you, Janae. I'm calling you, Stacy, a liar. Because unlike our friend Takesha, I didn't make a promise to you to keep your names out of my mouth. Because guess what, Janae? Or Stacy, I don't know which one of you dingbats said it, but you've poked the bear, so now you're gonna get the bear. Isn't that what you said?
He's off the road.
So now you've gotten the bear, and you're gonna continue to get the bear. And I am not letting up on you. And you can tell whatever uncle, cousin, mama, daddy, brother, sister, wife, that you have that works for the three-letter agencies, send them my way. I'll give them my phone number.
Well.
And with that, to everyone else other than those two dingbats, y'all have a blessed day.
Oh, my God. All right. Well, ladies and gentlemen, let's give Brother Nutty a round of applause. Now, listen. Now, many of you, again, I want to make sure how we got here. How did we get to the place where we're talking about poking the bear? Easy. They said it to Zeus.
Not necessarily you, maybe all your people. I do.
But can you not do that?
Hold on. You poke the bear. You poke the bear, you're going to get the bear.
Oh.
But I'll tell you right now, Zeus, the thing I don't like is when you go, and I've asked you 100 times over, Zeus, I'm blocking you, love. I'm blocking you. Just leave my name out of your mouth. Why should I have to go off? Hold on. Why should I have to go off? Because you want me to go off because you think... Geez, she's scared. I'm not scared. I don't like the death threat, sweetheart. The more rhetoric you push my direction, the more people hate.
Oh, right. Oh yes, look at that game. We got a beautiful friend.
Brother from another mother was born with you, handsome.
Hey, what's going on, beautiful? It's so nice to have you in this live. And what's Zeus? Oh my gosh, how are you?
I'm doing just fine. You know, spitting these straight, you hear me? That's all we can do. We can spit these straight facts, and like your mama said, tell the truth, shame the devil, baby. Ooh. We can't stop it. Won't stop. All gas, no brakes. I got something for them every fucking single day. Oh, excuse me, lady. Every single day. You understand me? I'm Muhammad Ali in the fight of my life. We gonna win. You understand that? They know what's going on. Holler if you hear me. And we are with all the shizits. You understand that? All right, then. I ain't gonna stay on here for that long, but I just wanted to tell you, keep doing your job. You are doing a wonderful job. You are one of the first people that I followed when I got on here.
Oh, wow.
And you, my brother, I definitely do. And love you to death.
I love you too. And please continue to do the great work you're doing, all right? I love it. It's really great work. You could actually act a lot further than I can.
baby, that's what they all said. We'll see. But you know, I'm going to keep on pushing because I don't care what profile I got to be on to do it. I'm going to keep pushing these facts.
Ooh. And that's a rhyme for your behind.
That part. I got to get back to my career. You hear me? But I'm going to head on and I'm going to keep on watching down. Comment Zeus, you keep it up, baby, and you tell Nutty I said he ain't got nothing on you, baby.
Hey. Thank y'all.
I'll see y'all in the comments. I appreciate y'all.
All right, I appreciate you and love you.
And keep on poking that bear.
I will and I shall.
All right, baby.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up to the beautiful straight facts. No lies. Detected. Oh, you know, I thought I was going to be a lot nicer today after that Closet of Truth situation. But when I woke up and I listened to the video all over again and I heard the bear business, I said, okay, hold on. We can't be kind to MAGA anymore, right? We can't be kind to them.
Everyone knows he's, and I wouldn't have said this 3 weeks ago.
I wouldn't have said it.
I was actually very kind to him. I was very kind to him, but now we can't be kind anymore because the gloves are off.
Right.
The jar has been opened.
Yes. The jar is open, Stacey and Janae. The bear has been poked. And the bear doesn't want to go back to sleep. No, the bear doesn't. All right, let's go back. Let's get into, let's bring up our next panelist. Oh my gosh. Dark Ange, welcome. How are you doing? Oh my gosh, what a show. Good morning.
I am well. Good morning.
Wow, you have brought me up after quite a, wow, those women, strong, strong women of Olympics.
Yeah, strong,
oh my goodness, strong women. Oh my goodness.
You're strong too, Ange, you're strong
Dang,
too.
Dang, no, I'm learning from them. Boss Diva is in my live a few nights ago. She said, come on, Ange, get that voice. Come on, girl. So, wow, what a lineup.
Yeah.
Anyway, and I want to say, I don't know if she's still in here, but welcome to Superwoman. I love seeing her in here. Holy crap. I have seen her go in the lion's den, and I'm in the lion's den. I won't mention any names because I don't need their BS after me again.
Yeah.
She went in the lion's den. She would take them all down.
Yeah.
That, she lives up to her name.
Wow. I believe it. I believe it. We got some real superheroes in this community.
We do. We do have some superheroes in here. Also, I would like to tell some of these people that were going after you yesterday. You do put in your research. You do your homework. I know you do. It shows. I've learned so much from you over these last, it's probably 7 or 8 months now, maybe longer.
Wow.
And I see you at night going around to the different lives and giving love back.
Yeah.
Giving the support to all of us, the encouragement, sending some gifts, you know, yes, snuggles, the homework.
Yes.
I see you down there. And, you know what? I know you don't like us to mute people, okay? And I try really hard not to, but Bushmaster, yeah, I muted you.
No.
Yes, I muted you. I just slapped his hand for 5 minutes, but he was sitting down there saying that Nutty does hurt and abuse women. So, yeah, I'll mute your ass. Oh, excuse my language. Sorry. I know. I try so hard. Now I'm going to move a little bit to politics. Our President Joseph Robert F. Biden, and his lovely wife, Dr. Jill Biden, they are in my state today.
Oh!
They're in my state today. They have come up to, to be with the people that have lost some loved ones up here last week.
Okay.
And yeah, wow. So anyway,
that's real leadership on display.
It really is. It really makes me happy. It warms my heart. I mean, this state, you know, that's only an hour for me, and you know, we were all closed down up here, and it means a lot to our state that our president would come up here. You know, Maine isn't really known.
Right.
We're known for lobster. If anybody is into lobster.
I am. I might have to take you up on that one day.
He is here with us. We are revisiting our pew-pew laws up here.
Okay.
We had yellow flag laws. This man had been reported multiple times, even by his own family, before this tragedy happened. So our representatives, I'll call him out. He's a Democrat. But I'll call him out, Representative Jared Golden. He was voting with the Republicans for no ban on these assault weapons. He is the Joe Manchin of Maine. He's disgusting. And I really hope they vote him out. But they're revisiting those laws. That makes me happy. Let's at least get to the red flag laws. We were only at yellow flag laws. So we can maybe avoid some of these tragedies again. But I'm very proud to have our president and our state today.
Exactly.
That's all I got. There goes my bell. I'll stay with that. And happy Friday to everyone.
Happy Friday. And Ange, as always, I appreciate you, you know, having the courage to get in here and tell the truth and update us with the facts like that. I really do appreciate it. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give the beautiful Ange a round of applause. See, ladies and gentlemen, it's not that hard to get in the box and tell the truth. That's what this is really all about. Let's go. Good morning, my good friend, Brother Swervin. How are you doing?
Good morning, Zeus. I'm doing pretty good. I'm looking forward to the weekend.
All right.
Me and the wife going to be making ourselves a nice big old pot of gumbo. as is tradition, as the winter weather starts setting in. We've been doing it for the past 28 years.
Wow. What do you mean? You said gumbo?
Yep.
Nice.
Some good old-fashioned Cajun seafood gumbo. And we will.
What kind of meat is in that gumbo? What kind of seafood?
We'll have some andouille sausage. My butcher up the street, he makes andouille sausage. We're gonna have some shrimp, some crab meat.
Jesus Christ!
Some celery, garlic, just a little bit of everything is going into it.
Ooh. Oh, that sounds delicious, my brother.
I cook my gumbo with beer, so.
Oh, you like to get a little of that bitterness going, huh?
Well, it's not just that, but you get more flavor going, and it helps to deglaze the pan because I pre-fry the shrimp a little bit.
Okay.
Just to get a good sear on them and deglaze the pan that the shrimp are in, and So yeah, it's good stuff. But
getting real starting to salivate over here. All right,
and my wife and I will be celebrating our 28th wedding anniversary.
Oh, congratulations!
Thank you. And it will be her birthday. Our anniversary is on the 20th. Her birthday is on the 25th.
Okay. Wow.
So got a lot going on this month, but that gumbo is definitely doing it for me. Let me tell you.
I can taste it. Listen, I'm over here about to put my bib on. I'm ask you to send a brother a plate, all right?
It's good stuff, brother. It's good stuff. Okay. So I wanted to go back to Ivanka if I could.
Let's get it.
Okay, because we didn't really know what her appeal was, what a ground she was appealing on.
Right.
Until the appeal was finalized. And now we find out that the appeal was based on it being a school week. Now, Zeus, listen.
Right.
You and I both know Ivanka and Jared Kushner don't have nothing to do with them kids. It's the nannies. It's the nannies that they throwing them kids off on. Hey, make sure they get to school on time.
Right.
Make sure they get their breakfast. Make sure they get to school. Make sure they do their homework. Otherwise, Ivanka ain't sitting there going over the homework with them kids. It's the man's.
Bingo.
Okay, so for her to sit here and say that it's a school week, you ain't taking them kids to school. It's your nanny taking them kids to school. It's your nanny fixing their lunch. It's your chef, your personal chef, more than likely, who's cooking you dinner.
You're right.
So you can't give up a few hours of your day to testify against your crooked father?
Oh.
Why? Because you just didn't want to testify against your crooked father. Even though this man has said some pretty despicable things towards his daughter.
Amen.
You know, like if she wasn't my daughter, perhaps I'd be dating her.
Oh, I remember and that nasty thing.
They say it was all a joke. He was just joking. What kind of father would let a sick-ass thought like that go through their head about their own daughter?
An evil one.
Yeah. My neighbor has daughters. I've never looked at them like, man, I love to date her.
Absolutely.
Not one time.
No.
You know, so the fact that he said these things and she, no. Look, honey, this is your opportunity to get up on that stand and tell the truth of the people and tell the truth of what your corporation did.
Exactly.
If you can't tell the truth of what your corporation did because you love daddy so much, then you should have never been involved in that corporation. Because if you were, you knew daddy was doing some fraudulent things.
Exactly.
It's like, as the executives of the company, yeah, you can pay your CPAs all you want to, but the buck stops with you, not your CPAs. The buck doesn't stop with your CPAs. The buck doesn't stop with your accounting department. The buck stops with you. Why? Because you are in charge. You want to say how much you're in charge of the corporation, but then when the corporation gets crawled to the carpet on something, it was the accountant's fault and the CPA's fault and this person did this and they just assumed that Trump wanted that. Right. Now the buck still stops with you, my friend.
Amen. And that's what real leadership is about.
Exactly. And Ivanka, just get off this train of it's a school week. Because I guarantee you, when they have a day off for like Veterans Day, I guarantee you ain't spending no time with them kids.
Oh.
You got your nanny spending time with them kids while you off on the beach somewhere. Let's be real.
Exactly.
Let's be real.
Let's be real. I like that.
Like them kids say, let's keep it real because I'm keeping it real. That's real.
Amen.
She knows she ain't spending no time with them kids. I mean, let's just come on, man.
Yeah.
Ain't nobody.
I doubt it.
Ain't nobody buying it. It's too expensive and she shouldn't be trying to sell it. Pure and simple.
Exactly. Bingo.
So
bingo, bingo.
All right, brother. I'm going to let you go ahead and get back to managing the affairs of the kingdom.
All right.
I'm making my grocery list for my gumbo, so I'm looking forward to doing that tomorrow.
All right. And, I love it.
I will see you all later. If I don't get to see you all, have a great weekend. Be safe, and please, please, please have fun while you're doing it. Bingo. Take care, Zeus.
All right, all right, all right, ladies and gentlemen. You too take care, Brother Swervin. Let's give Swervin a round of applause. Detected, all right? All right, ladies and gentlemen, we've reached the conclusion of today's show, and it is now time for Zeus to go and tend to other affairs in the kingdom. I know, we could keep going. We could. All right? We could keep going, but you know, I love each and every single one of you the same, all right? Wait a second. Okay. Hold on. Bear with me. Oh, yes. Why do you keep wanting to come into the live, Snuggles?
How you doing? Yeah, I just
this is the Lion's Den.
Yes. Hey, I don't care if I'm poked. I just wanted to know why you made fun of my Velcro shoes.
Oh, if the shoe fits, wear it. right.
Yeah.
You need to step it up, Snuggles. Listen, you really shouldn't be in a relationship. If you're dating a woman and you're living at home in your mom's or grandma's basement wearing Velcro shoes, that's just not a sign you can take on the responsibilities.
Sounds good. Hey, listen, I actually agree with Swervin when it came to Ivanka.
What is that?
I mean, yeah, she doesn't know her kids. That's great. But also, I like when he said she's at the beach. And so was her. So was Eric and Don Jr. Right? When their accountants did the business work.
Let me ask you a question real quick. Okay, since you agree and you're in an agreeable mode, Can I ask you a question, Snuggles? Since you're in an agreeable mode,
yes.
Who would you say is responsible for the attack on the Capitol on January 6th?
Oh, Nancy Pelosi.
That felt good. Nothing like dropping MAGA from the box. Woo! Snuggles, you're wrong. You're wrong and you're losing, champ. Nice try. It is Donald Trump, sir, who is responsible for the attack on the Capitol on January 6th. And Snuggles, I got another question. And this is for you MAGA demons. If Donald Trump, Bushmaster, this one's for you. If Donald Trump was such a great leader, as you say, why didn't he get a second term? If he was so great, why did he get a second term and lose to President Biden and Kamala Harris? Now ponder on that. All right, I'm out of here, ladies and gentlemen, and I do hope each and every single one of you enjoyed this show, all right? And Stacy and Janae, I do hope you learned something, all right? If you poke the bear, you gotta take what's coming when the bear wakes up. So stop poking the bear. And I would encourage all of you who don't like this live or the people that come up to just get off of TikTok. Go back to Facebook. Go on to X. Just block me. Block Zeus, block all of us, and go on about your miserable lives, doing what you've been doing. Losing and being fools for Donald Trump. That's the best you can do. Because after that, it's a wrap. It's over. Jail or hell is all we're offering for you Trump supporters.
Two forwards, most handsome in the kingdom.
And I really am the most handsome.
Oh.
Take care, ladies and gentlemen.
This is how I move when I'm walking like Zeus. This is how I sound.
Thank you, little
like
hawk, Zeus. My brother.
This is how I stare when I'm looking like
Mamba
Zeus.
Energy, yes.
When I'm moving like Zeus. Don't be
hey, yes.
Moving like Zeus.
Yes, jail or hell, that's all MAGA gets.
Thunder in the sky like you up like Zeus.
I make my own rules. Ready!
I'm higher than the eagle and got bread on me too. Took a long
oh yeah, I gotta get it too. I know Janae is here.
Living like a bum. Get
away I know she's
me.
Here.
Oh, I got money in your
here you go, Janae.
I can leave it up to you.
This is
I
for you, Janae.
With you. You fall in love too.
Stacy.
You a high risk.
They got jungle fever.
I put a bounty on your head. This is way above feds. When you playing with the gods,
hey,
you playing
let's
with
go!
The time to let loose with the truth. Yeah, grab your goose.
Hey, little mama, let me play with your caboose.
I know
not
you babies
busy,
love me cause I'm sweet
today.
Like a tooth.
Play a hating on the gods, boy, you're such a douche.
I tried to be patient, but you had a
mess
of kids. I'm catching all these snakes like a mongoose.
Have a great weekend.
I'm so handsome,
yeah.
That's why they call me man. This is how I move when I'm walking like
Miss
Zeus.
Ah.
This is how I sound when I'm talking like Zeus.
Oh, it triggers them.
I like to act a fool when I'm moving like
I know it does. Because they know that they are in love with Zeus. Angel, thank you, Miss Paul Diva, thank you. They are in love with Zeus. They're in love with all the Democrats. And they want to fit in. But they can't. Because their hearts are wicked. Slick as Rick. Their hearts are wicked. They got lust in their heart. They lust after Zeus. You should see them. Dark and
if you
don't they lust
don't be in the
oh they got I would love you know how Biden flicks that ice cream cone that's what they think about when they think about
like
Zeus. Chasing your name cut it out
yeah, grab your goose. Hey, little mama,
I've said it before and I'll say it again
like a tooth.
You gonna have to lay there and burn yeah
you're
gonna lay there and burn with that demon.
Like
thank you, Dark Hands.
These ladies
keep
love
it
me,
clean.
Yeah, I'm the one that they choose. You know I'm so handsome. That's why they call me Zeus. This is how I move when I'm walking like
Link in the bio. Yes,
this
is Miss B, I see ya.
Like
Dark Hands, I love you,
too. This is how I stare when I'm looking like Zeus.
Yeah.
I like to act
you're gonna lay there and burn, ladies.
Like don't be playing with my
all right, and even if there was an opportunity, you can't start in the front of the line. You gotta get all the way at the back of the line and wait your
God, call me Zeus.
I just want to buy 11,780 one more than we have.
And that's the crime. That's when he knew that it's time to go ahead and indict him. That's what he did. He did it on this. Let's go, Reggie!
He's deranged. Jackson. He's deranged. Jackson. He's deranged.
Yeah, you heard
Jackson.
That
he's deranged. Jackson. He's deranged. Jackson. He's deranged.
Yeah,
Jackson.
It's me.
He's deranged.
It's Zeus.
Jackson. Donald Trump is indicted when they take one charge and they turn it into 36 charges.
It's a heck of a magic trick, right? One charge, 36 charges. That's one heck of a magic trick, all right? All right, all right. Now, Janae, Stacy, one last time. One more time. It's Friday, right? It's okay to let your hair down. Hey. Love some Zeus. about the night now. Oh, I'm done. They in their feelings. Now, Stacey and Janae, I expect to see you in my DMs as usual. I'm out of here. Take care, ladies and gentlemen.